We are now approaching Clydebank.
My name's Ian McGuinness and I'm a filmmaker. I grew up in Clydebank and I've always thought that the town doesn't get the recognition that places like Coventry and London get, but in terms of the concentration of death and destruction, Clydebank came off much worse. As the 70th anniversary passes, I've decided to make this film in order to share some of the survivors' personal experiences with you. Some stories are inspiring and many are emotional. These are their stories of the Clydebank Blitz.
And we were 10 minutes in when the bomb landed there, and he went to look, my mother pulled him back, and as soon as she pulled him back, it blew up.
During World War II, both the John Brown and Company shipyard and Singers contributed massively to the Allies' campaigns with battleships, weapons and munitions.
This meant that the Nazis inevitably targeted the town. Over two nights, the 13th and 14th of March 1941, Clydebank suffered the worst destruction and civilian loss of life in all of Scotland. Out of approximately 12,000 houses, only 7 remained undamaged, with 4,000 completely destroyed and 4,500 severely damaged. This map shows the locations of the bombs that fell, with the larger circles indicating more powerful explosives and larger blast radii.